all-new SCOTT Lumen eRIDE. New name, new category, but familiar silhouette. It may look like a spark with the motor, but there's a lot more going on here. 130 millimeters of travel, 15.5 kilos. Let's get into it a little bit more back at the office, if we can ever get this guy off the trail, that is. Even 5 years ago, it was easy to recognize the difference between an EMTB and an MTB. But today, be ready to answer the question, is it a spark or is it an e-bike? I'm in the SCOTT Museum today because we're already talking about history for e-bikes. 10 years, 5 generations, no bike category has been evolving as fast. Let's see what's improved since the e-spark and why. First and most notably, the integration. Integration gives more freedom for a better geometry with lower bottom bracket, improved center of gravity, and shorter chain stays. And of course, it improves the aesthetic as well. From a 100% leisure bike with a not so fashion image, e-bikes became a training tool for the pros, a racing sport, a free ride bike, but most of the time, just a ton of fun. With products like the Lumen, not only are the design barriers between regular MTB and EMTB reduced, but the riding feel is as close as ever. What do we mean by this? Well, the geometry has been sorted for a few years, the design too. What remains is the weight, the last element of differentiation, which still splits the riding sensation of an EMTB from a regular MTB. It's not a secret, e-bikes used to have a red flag on the scale and handling was slightly different on the trails due to the additional kilos. At SCOTT, we give a lot of attention to the weight, so we couldn't resist tackling the e-bike category and arriving with an EMTB with the weight of a regular MTB. I have with me part of the development team for the Lumen, consisting of product management, engineering, and design. The holy trinity, you might say. And I have some questions for them. Let's start with Fred. It looks like a spark, but how did you manage to integrate the electrical system?
The design goal was to keep the spark volume and aesthetic with a motor. For that, we needed to have a smaller drive unit. We realized by working with TQ that the new motor fit our requirements. In the end, just by moving the shock and slightly extending the chainstay, we could fit the drive unit. Regarding the battery fit, it was surprisingly almost for free. The down tube dimension just slightly increased. So we end up with an e-bike visually very close to the spark.
I love speaking to the development team. Everything sounds easy. Second question, it's an e-bike, it has a motor. Why do you care so much about pedaling and weight efficiency?
Well, Ben, here again, it's relatively easy. So first, the TQ HPR50 delivers 50 Newton meter of torque by only 1.8 kilogram, which is already one of the best on the market. To understand this benefit a bit better, we have to dive a bit into rocket science and have to put a ratio in place, which is the power to weight ratio, which is used a lot in road cycling or in the car industry. So let's compare different bikes from our range to understand this power to weight ratio much better. First of all, the Pattern eRIDE, which is our most powerful e-bike in the line. Then we put the Lumen and, as a comparison, the Spark. So for the maximum motor power, we obviously have a much higher number on the Pattern than on the Spark, which comes with our drive system. Then we took an average of 250 watts for the leg power for your own input, added this up, divided by the overall bike weight, and we came up with the power to weight ratio, which obviously is better if it's higher than low.
Okay, so if I read this right, then am I faster on a Lumen?
On very steep uphills, probably not. But on the regular climb, I would say the battle is definitely open. The mix out of the lightweight construction of the Lumen, the pedaling efficiency from the Spark, and the HPR50 drive system is definitely a game changer. It's basically like having legs like Nino Schurter, just on demand. And as a cherry on the cake, there's nothing. It's very silent.
But, and what about range?
Of course, the battery is smaller, but the low weight and the low drag requires less watts from you as a rider. So basically, this opens up the option of riding in a low assist mode or even with the motor switched off.
Okay, you've convinced me about weight and about pedaling efficiency, but all my friends ride with a big battery and I want to keep riding with my friends, right?
Of course, in this case, you can simply add a range booster on your bike, plug and play, and you can increase your battery capacity up to 520 watt-hours, which gives you a range of about 60 kilometers.
Charlie, you're the engineer behind the Spark, and obviously you've put a lot of time into riding both bikes with Andy. How do you account for the differences and similarities between the bikes?
A funny story is, when I started developing the Spark, I couldn't feel Nino's feedback as he was way too fast. Now with the Lumen, I completely get what he was saying and everybody can benefit from it. Having a world champ bike as a base could only be a big benefit for this kind of bike where pedal efficiency is needed. The Spark is also known as to be the best in the downhill in its category. We pushed that quality even further with 10 mm of additional travel. And of course, we had to adjust the carbon layers to stiffen the e-pack area and make sure that there's no loss of energy while pedaling. As you can see on the animation, we continue to fine-tune our stiffness backbone, the low part of the bike where the higher forces are applied, pedal and shock. The whole integration also helps as we achieve a simple tube shape that are best for our stiffness to weight ratio, thanks to perfect carbon fiber continuity.
Okay, cool. But Andy, you have a long history with SCOTT with e-bikes. You've been here for over 10 years. Integration is a really hot topic for us. Can you tell us maybe about why integration was so important on this bike?
Basically, the best example on the Lumen are the two water bottle cages. Up to now, and also currently, you sacrifice your water bottle with a second battery on your down tube, which will end up in a bigger capacity but less water. So, longer ride, less water? Sounds a bit weird, doesn't it? On the Lumen, we have the luck of having a very compact drive system from the HPR 50 and the integrated shock together with the down tube battery that we could achieve two water bottle cages. So depending on your ride and on your day, you could actually choose if you want to ride either two bottles if you're very thirsty, so you have one on down tube, one on the C tube, or you can actually add a quick release adapter which allows you to plug and play on the down tube either the range extender or the bottle.
So from the range booster, let's move to what you can see on the top of the bike and talk about the integrated display.
Exactly. So obviously you want to have a certain amount of information during your ride. That's why we integrated this LED screen flush into your top tube. And like this, it's well protected. You cannot miss it at home. Nobody can steal it. And it's always there.
So you can see info like watts, cadence, power, battery capacity, stuff like that. And the bike connects automatically with your phone on Bluetooth. It works with AMP Plus with your Garmin.
Exactly, and not only this, but also if you plug your range booster, the display goes up to 150% state of charge.
Moving to the cockpit, integration is a key point here. The cockpit is also cleaner thanks to the integration of the screen in the top tube. We've also got cleaner integration for Garmin units and we've managed to integrate the cables better. How did you approach the additional cables?
We worked on a routing solution that keeps all the cables tidy along the handlebar and bring them directly into the frame by the headset. When we developed the combo for the Spark, we anticipated those extra cables already that e-bikes have. That's why we could keep everything tidy with all identical parts. Goal is to ensure good longevity of the cables. Integration also helps us routing all the cables as close as possible to all the pivots of the bike, so headset and main pivots. We can then achieve low extension as possible to get nice functionality. We also thought about maintenance and mechanics with dedicated channel inside the frame and an easy access thanks to the big hatch under the down tube.
Okay, and Andy, what other features do we have?
So there is actually a valve extender to facilitate the adjustment of your air pressure in your rear shock. There is obviously a chainstay protector out of soft rubber to silence your bike due to chain slap. And there is a rear axle tool integrated as on any other SCOTT bike with a T30, T25 and a 6mm Allen key.
Okay, cool. That was constructive. Thanks, guys. The bike is available in four sizes, from small to extra large. You'll find all the information on our website. In the meantime, I think it's finally time to go riding. See you out there.